Hi, I'm Howard Lothrop, host of Echo Partners TV, and I'm here today to talk with you about how EVE, your economic value of equity, is related to earnings at risk. You know, we spoke a few episodes ago about how you measure interest rate risk and talked about the three main ways of doing so: GAAP, earnings at risk, and EVE. And the biggest difference between EVE and earnings at risk is the time horizon. Generally, even though you might look at a multi-year horizon with earnings at risk, people are focused on a 12-month horizon. Whereas with EVE, you're looking at a very, very long-term horizon. Here's the key. If you extend your earnings at risk simulation to longer and longer periods to fully capture longer and longer prepayment events and repricing events, over time, those multi-period earnings at risk numbers will tend to approach your EVE results. So what you might say is, and this is, I think, a really good way to look at this, is that EVE shows you the very, very long-term results of earnings at risk given the bank's current interest rate risk position. Now, it's important to realize that all of these measurements assume static balance sheet and do not offer changes in management strategy. So, of course, they can all be taken for what they are, and that is, they're good indications of areas where you might have risk, but they're also areas where management can make the biggest impact. Thanks very much, and we'll see you on the next episode.